Skills and talents that will benefit you in all aspects of life. Whether you know it or not, you've been working on teamwork skills, the ability to blend sounds and achieve a unified musical expression, discipline, strong work ethic, dedication, communication skills. Did you know music is a form of communication? And you really have to listen and respond to each other. Confidence, your ability to be on the stage this evening to perform for this audience, build self-esteem and stage presence. And time management, one important life skill. Juggling your music practice, your schoolwork, and other obligations you have are important for success in life. And most importantly, we hope you leave tonight and this experience with joyful memories and experiences you won't forget. So this evening, I also want to thank our outstanding music teachers who are conducting festival this year. Tonight at our festival orchestra is Emily Caravella. And if you're seeing around for band or chorus, Michael Bowles and Katie McLean. One of the most amazing things about the music department is a sense of family and teamwork. This performance of students in grades 5 through 12 wouldn't be possible without the support of all the district music teachers that go above and beyond. They have helped with rehearsals. Many of them are here tonight helping with tonight's concert. And the list goes on and on for months and months. So a special thank you to all the music teachers that are here tonight and our administrators that are supporting the program. So thank you. And students, let's thank your parents, your grandparents, your neighbors, your friends, those of you that have carpooled. Did you ever bring a late instrument into school? Forgotten instrument? Reminders of practicing, without your support at home, this also wouldn't be possible. So to all you adults in the audience, thank you. Just a couple logistical reminders. Tonight's performance will be live streamed on Blue Eagle News and recorded for your enjoyment. If you have a cell phone, please remember to silence your phone so that doesn't disrupt the performance tonight. And if you have any instruments at home that are gently used and like to donate, we want to inspire future musicians in the future, so we are accepting gently used instruments. You can drop them off at any of your schools. If you have any at home or if anybody would like to donate instruments, we're always accepting them to put them back in the hands of our students. And with that said, I am going to turn it over with excitement and anticipation of tonight's concert to Miss Emily Caravella and the Festival Orchestra.
Hi everyone, I'm Emily Caravella. I am instrument of music at Silas Dean Middle School and I direct the Elementary Festival Orchestra. I am so proud of all of these students, both on the stage, to the sides of the stage. It's just been an incredible experience, and I'm really excited to showcase our string department district-wide to you. The first piece we're going to be playing is called Gaelic Castle. Thank you. If you're a festival helper and leader, can you please stand up so we can recognize you? Could you wave at us if you're a graduating senior? I'm putting them on the spot. I know they don't like this, but. So some of these students have been on stage with this orchestra since pretty much fourth or fifth grade, and now they're going to college, and they've dedicated a lot of time, both at the SDMS and high school level, to be with us every single week. Some of that was, you know, when they were in the middle of playing Edwin Drood or Mary Poppins. They were basically living at the high school and the middle school. They spent hours and hours, and I really appreciate you guys spending hours and hours picking up, dropping off, and dropping off food, because they were here for like 14 hours, but. The amount of time that every single one of these musicians have spent on the stage to really create an incredible program. I'm just really grateful that I get to work with them, and I'm really grateful for their hard work. Our last piece for this part of the program is called Dragon Hunter, and I think you'll realize that it's probably our favorite piece.
Thank you.
Stay tuned for a quick scene change where we get the middle school up here and the elementary school in town, and we'll proceed with our program in a second. Thank you.
Thank you. forward.
Changeover than I expected. Awesome. This is the SDMS Chamber Orchestra. These awesome, amazing middle schoolers wake up at like the crack of dawn to rehearse at 7 a.m. on Tuesdays, which is incredible in its own whole field. But these kids are just awesome, kind, energetic. They're really, really supportive of each other, and it makes for like the best morning ever every Tuesday. So we really appreciate them. We will be playing Thriller for you first. A little bit different for an orchestra. We like to change things up. And we have some guest soloists that are part of our ensemble, but they're really adding a lot to the rock portion of this piece. So we have Dean on bass guitar with Mr. Park on bass guitar. And we have Zach Centrilli coming back on the drum set. Tremolos. We've done a lot of growing through this, learning a lot of cool bow techniques and really stretching what string instruments can do. Our next song is Feed the Birds from Mary Poppins. the middle school, a lot of these students actually performed in Mary Poppins, some of our students over here as well. We spent a lot of time with Mary Poppins, and we thought it would be a really cool way to just show how proud we are that we got to accomplish that piece. Feed the Birds is one of the gorgeous pieces from that musical, so we hope you enjoy. Since you're still wearing winter jackets, even though it's spring, it'll still be appropriate. So enjoy Wizards of Winter for our last piece.
Thank you.
teenager.
We're going to do a quick changeover over to the high school program directed by Mr. Michael Bowles.
Thank you. Greetings, everyone. As Ms. Calabella said, I am Michael Bowles. I'm the band director and orchestra director here at Wethersfield High School. I am excited to share with you the Wethersfield High School Concert Orchestra. The tune you just heard was called Air for Buenos Aires. It featured quite a few soloists, if you pop them kind of throughout the orchestra. I was a little nervous when I gave them that piece because I wasn't sure if anybody was going to bite and like volunteer to take a solo. But pretty much, we had probably about 10 or 15 people set up to the plate, want to play some of those sections with that group. It's been a really fantastic thing to put together. The next thing we're going to do for you is a little bit unusual, because this is a concert that I feel like is a great chance for us to talk about music and what music looks like to all the levels. And you've seen the elementary, the middle school, and the high school. But one thing that I'd like to demonstrate for you is why music is very different for a student's education. And these wonderful people are going to help me do that behind me. And I'm not going to take any credit for this demonstration. I've stolen this from somebody way more intelligent than I am. But I think it's really effective to show why music is very different. In every class that a student does throughout the day, with the exception of music, they are an individual for the most part. It's their math test, it's their essay, it's their assignment. You know, they really just affect themselves. And we want them to do well, we want them to do that thing. But in this room, and in this group, every student has to be functioning at almost 100% perfection the whole time for it to even remotely sound like music. And we're gonna demonstrate why and how that works. So all these kids up here and all the ones you've seen today are being asked to do a lot of things. They're being asked to watch a conductor. They're being asked to listen to their peers. They're being asked to play an instrument, which involves being able to read a foreign language. All of these symbols tell each student how long the note is, how loud the note is, what type of bowing they're supposed to do, where they're supposed to put that finger, and all of that happens at exactly the same moment every single time, every single second, every single note throughout every single piece of music. And it really starts to add up, and it's a lot on a student to do that and accomplish that. So it's not really just playing that instrument, it's so much more that goes in with that. And it matters up here because everybody matters on the stage. Everybody's equal and everybody contributes and everybody's incredibly important. And if we're all not achieving at our highest level, it sounds really bad. We're going to demonstrate one little thing. So we're going to take a section of music of the piece we're about to play, and we're going to play it as close to 100% as we can. This is every right note, every right rhythm, everything is perfect. This is as best as we can do it. This is like 95%, maybe 99.5. Listed out like five rhythm notes, all that stuff. We're going to take just pitch. That's the right note at the right time. They're going to play the right rhythm. They're going to play with good style. They're going to play with the right dynamic. But all they're going to do is reduce their accuracy to 90% correct notes. That's one element of music that they're doing. And you're going to hear a noticeable difference.
90%. One, two, three, four,
still a tune, okay? That's an A in any other academic subject. You could be a doctor with it, okay? You could also be a doctor with a B. So this is 80% accuracy. If it were me and I came home with an 80% on my calculus test, I would be very proud of this. Here we go.
80%.
It has to be achieved by every student. That's just something that they don't get anywhere else. That's only something that we could do in this room, because if you look at any other activity they do, the group is important, but there's usually a sub. There's usually a halftime. There's a bench. There's a second game. We don't get to, you know, stop halfway through the tune and go back in the orchestra room and talk about how we can go get measure 23 better. We've got to do it this one time in this one shot. And so that music education is really helps build their sense of community, their sense of team, and that responsibility to each other. And we really, really want to foster that. And that's why it's really exceptional what they can do by playing these instruments for you here tonight. And just for grins, let's hear what a C sounds like. C's get degrees, I'm just saying. The point is that it really is a high demand thing, and that's just one element we changed to 90% accuracy, 80%. Just imagine if we were only operating at 50%. We were at 100% all the time, every time. And just so your ears feel a little better, here's what it sounded like at 100%. About your next stage in a musical career and you're watching everything that's going on, I just want you to think a little bit about what's really happening, especially when we get 100 of these musicians up here together in just a minute, and how much that really takes to put together. Before we play our last tune, I just want to say thank you to everybody in the audience. I want to say thank you to these folks behind me because they're doing a stellar job, and to the elementary and middle school orchestra students. This tune's a little weird. There's a lot of weird stuff, and you're going to see a lot of you're gonna see a lot of things that, like, I know the middle school's been talking about, especially elementary. We're gonna play the instruments in ways that we've never talked about. We're gonna see some body percussion. We saw some harmonics and things in the last piece. We're gonna see a lot of different things in a lot of different ways to play this. So I hope you really enjoy kind of just another side of the orchestra. So this is Babylon. Thank you.
take just a brief second. We're going to bring all of our street musicians on stage.
While we're still getting a little bit settled, I'll just go over the dismissal procedure so you guys all know that before we all end and celebrate. So all high schoolers are going back to the band room to pack up, and then they'll meet you in their high schooler way over here. Elementary and SDMS is going to pack up from the CAF, and then they're going to either meet you in the CAFs to go out those doors if you parked over football field side, or if you parked poolside entrance off of J Street, you guys can go all the way out this way. We do have a festival band concert coming in, so we do ask you celebrate and then leave if you don't mind, so that the band can come in, because there's going to be a lot more students coming in for the 7 o'clock concert. Just to echo what Mr. Bull said, I appreciate all of you for all of your hard work, all of you. I appreciate all of you for all of your driving and support, and I appreciate all of my colleagues and the administrators here who have helped jump into action so that I can do cello surgery while we get 100 kids on the stage. So it's just a really awesome experience, and I appreciate everybody here. Our last song is Over the Rainbow. We hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
was not for you guys time to go celebrate and go home and eat good food and just think of the awesome work. Stay on stage for 1 second. Reminder to parents, high schoolers are going to be over there. SDMS and elementary are going to be there. If you can give them about 1 minute to set pack up before they go out and meet you, that would be awesome. Thank you so much for coming again.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening.
I'm Selena Soli, Assistant Superintendent, and I'm super excited to welcome you to this evening's Festival Bend concert. So let's give a round of applause for our students. Since January, and I want to talk a little bit about the skills that you're learning in different ensembles. So performing a music ensemble isn't just about playing right notes, but it is important. But it's about developing valuable skills and experiences with your friends and your teachers. You've been working on teamwork together. You've been listening to each other, blending your sounds, and working to perfection. You've been learning discipline, dedication, hard work, teamwork, communication. Did you know that music is a form of communication and you have to communicate with each other to really have an amazing song? How many of you are working on time management? Juggling all of your schoolwork, your other demands, your music practice, really life important life skills. And most importantly, in addition to the skills I mentioned, I hope you all have great memories of the joy, the fun you have together, and lasting memories forever of festival. I also want to thank our outstanding music teachers, Mr. Bowles, for conducting elementary band, festival bands. Conductors Emily Caravella and Katie McLean. The festival concerts are one of my favorite nights of the year. It's really a special experience with students, especially with our district-wide music teachers. The music teachers work incredibly hard together. There's a sense of family and commitment. Many of our music teachers from across the district are here to support. So a round of applause to all our music teachers and administrators here tonight. And a special thank you to the parents, aunts, uncles, grandparents, older siblings, for your carpooling, your reminders of practice, and maybe once in a while drop an instrument off at school. Does that happen? Maybe. The parents, thank you very much. A couple logistical things. We are streaming tonight's performance live on Blue Eagle News, and it will be recorded. Please remember to silence your cell phones so we don't have any disruptions during the concerts tonight. And we continue to inspire more musicians each and every year. We're always collecting gently used instruments. So if you are doing some spring cleaning, or you know a neighbor or a friend that has a gently used instrument they'd like to put in the hands of a new musician, we'd gladly take those donations that can be dropped off at any school. So with that, I am super excited to get the concert started, and I will turn it over to Mr. Bowles and the Elementary Festival Band.
Thank you.
Testing one, great. Thank you very much for coming this evening. As mentioned, I am Mr. Bowles. I have had the honor of directing the festival band for, I can't remember which year this is now, but it's been at least 4 or 5 years. It really is a great experience to put all of these musicians together from other buildings, and really we've had about 8 hours of rehearsal to put together what you're seeing today. I'm also the band director at the high school, and this is really the highlight of my week because it really is a wonderful group of students. And so all of you elementary students, especially, I want to say thank you for all of your hard work and your energy, because it's been really fun to put this together, and I hope that you're enjoying, we got one out of the way, two more to go, your performance here tonight. I've just been overly thrilled to share this time with you. You're all absolutely amazing. The next thing we're going to play for you is a song by Robert W. Smith, who is a pretty famous band composer, but unfortunately, we lost him this last year, so I really want to make it a point to play a Robert W. Smith tune because he's written a lot of great music for a lot of young musicians. And this one has a little bit of an influence, and this one's called The Tempest. See? Shakespeare, right? See? High school kids do it. I just want to thank a few people who are clearly not in elementary school on the stage behind me. We have the privilege every year of having a whole lot of volunteers from the high school and the middle school who come and not only sit in and play with these musicians every week, especially in the percussion section, they're actually helping teach them and show them instruments that they've never played and never used, because in all of our elementary schools we don't have access to things like timpani and things. So for some of them, this is the first time they've gotten to play that instrument, was in these rehearsals. And I just want to thank all of those high school and middle school musicians who have joined us here today. So if you're one of those musicians, can you stand up right now? And very much for a lot of time. Also, just want to say thank you to all of my elementary colleagues in the district. You know, they do a lot of work and effort to get these students prepared for this experience. Give them music, go over with them in their lessons, and make sure that they are ready to kind of get into this full setting, and I just enjoyed all this time, and I just want to say thank you to all of them. I hope you like the Festival Band's last tune called Shockwave.
Thank you. Thank you. by Herbie Hancock called Chameleon, and this has been a really fun one for us to learn. It's got a little bit of group improvisation while we're all trying to play off of each other, and it's just a lot of fun.
Thank you.
While they shuffle around a little bit, I'm just going to tell you a little bit about the group that's in front of you. This is the Wethersfield High School Symphonic Band. What that means is every student in here, and including the percussionists in the back, receive honors credit for being a part of the band program. This is our top band here at the high school. They've had a busy few weeks. A lot of these folks were not only involved with the musical that happened just recently, but last weekend, two weekends ago, we were invited to perform at the United States Coast Guard Academy. So the program you're hearing today is part of that program we performed on. These folks have to go down to the Coast Guard Academy and receive master classes and clinics with the bandsmen of the Coast Guard Band, perform in their concert hall, and then receive an on-stage side-by-side clinic where members of their band came and joined our students, and they worked with the conductor of the Coast Guard Band for about 40 minutes. It was a really great opportunity for them, and they've certainly done a wonderful job. The next tune is actually called Loch Lomond, but if you know the tune Danny Boy, I want you to have a little ear out, because it kind of shows up at the end a little bit. But it's a very beautiful band tune. It kind of shows off some more musical side of this group.
Thank you.
Musicians have been asked here to do this evening, especially some of these young musicians out here who are going to join us up here in just a second. What it takes to play an instrument, what it takes to play an ensemble is so much more than being able to play your flute. And you have to be able to play your flute with 45 other musicians. And while you play your flute, you have to listen to those musicians. You have to know how to read a foreign language, which tells you a ton of information every second that you go by. Each of these little symbols not only tells you what key to push down, it also tells you how long to play that note, how fast to play that note, how loud or soft to play that note, how short to play that note. Does it need an emphasis? Is it connected to the next note? Do you have to speed up? Do you have to slow down? All that happens on every single beat of every single piece of this music that they have to play here in front of you. Why don't you think about that for a second? It's a lot going on at that time. But what that means is that every student on the stage and all these ensembles you've heard today have to be at 100% efficiency and 100% effectiveness for it to work. It really has to be every student, every second, every note at 100%. Otherwise, it doesn't work. And that's nothing they do in their school day ever asks that of every student in the room. Now, we want everybody to be awake in math and give 100% of math, but if you get a B on your math test, that doesn't mean that the other person's math test is going to go down, probably. But up here, it really is every person, every note, every day, and that's really something different that they get to experience in their school day. And I want to kind of have you wrap your head around this for a little bit, and we're going to play a little bit of this next tune that we're going to play for you, and we're going to demonstrate just what a little change in effectiveness can do to some music. So we're going to play about 6 measures of music, and as a close to 100% as we can get. I think we're pretty close to 100%. Okay. Here we go. Here's those 6 measures. Okay. That's about as close as we can get to 100% accuracy with everything I've just described. Notes, rhythms, dynamics, articulations, all of those things. I'm going to ask these students on the stage, every single one of them, to reduce one of those elements of music to a 90%. So they're going to take all the notes they play, and they're going to play 90% of those notes accurate. They're still going to play at the right time, they're still going to play the right rhythm, they're still going to play with a good tone, but they're only going to miss 90% of the notes. For some students, that's one note. I think for 8, it's like 2 notes. For the flutes, it's like 6 notes over the course of this measure, but it's 10%. That's an A. That is valedictorian material. Here we go. They put one button down wrong at one time. Let's see what a B sounds like. To this mission and this goal of playing for you. And unlike anything they do in their lives, there's no halftime, there's no bench, there's no C team, we're not gonna take a break here, go chat it out, get some oranges, and come back out here and finish the tune for you. It's true. We get one shot to do it. And that's what's different. We're expecting every student on their stage to be at their best for this moment in time so that we can share our best with you here tonight. This tune you probably don't know. If you do, you watch some really strange movies. It's written by a very famous composer named John Williams. You may have heard a tune or two that he's written. The movie is called 1941, which is actually directed by Steven Spielberg after Jaws, so he was rich and famous, but he made this horrible movie. If you want to go watch it, go for it. But the march is amazing. It's cheeky, it's fun, and we had a really good time playing with this Coast Guard band, and we really enjoyed it. So I hope you like the march from 1941. brief second, we're going to get all of our elementary and middle school friends up on here for our big grand finale here tonight.
Thank you.
Before we play our final number here this evening, I just want to say thank you to all of you for coming out and supporting band and supporting music here in Wethersfield. And again, I want to say thank you to all of my colleagues. I want to say thank you to my wife. I want to say thank you to all the administration. They've all been incredibly supportive of everything that we do here. I just want to thank them for that. After we finish this last tune, a few instructions for you. If you're an elementary parent, will you raise your hand? You can collect your students from the cafeteria where you drop them off here today. Middle school, you can meet them out in the lobby because they're going to grab their cases from here and head out toward the front doors of the auditorium after they finish. If we avoid coming in the back hallway, that'd be great because it'll be a little chaotic here for a second. High school parents and students, if you don't have it figured out by now, I can't help you. But you can just collect your students as you normally do. But again, thank you all for coming out this evening, and my most sincere thanks because this is the biggest joy. You have no idea how hard it is to do this. Can think of way worse ways to make money. But I really do enjoy the students, and I hope you enjoy this really mass piece here of over 100 musicians on the stage. It's called River Rendezvous. My composer is Michael Sweet.